At its simplest, short-termism is being locked into a cycle where the here and now kind of eclipses our abilities to think or plan for the long term. And I think it's something that's particularly kind of endemic in our always-on digital-first culture that we have now. It feels like digital as technology has almost pressed the fast-forward button on society, and it prestiges things that are kind of now, next, instant.
I could pick up my phone now and I could spend hundreds of pounds instantly. And what happens is we get that little dopamine hit. Oh, that was nice. I feel better now because I was feeling kind of a bit crappy before and this has kind of sorted it out for me. That's a slight problem because obviously what you're doing then is you're getting short-term satisfaction, but not actually thinking long-term. And this applies to your financial life. It applies to your relationship life. It's everywhere in your whole system.
Most people I know, even among my closest friends, who I have so much in common with in terms of, you know, we work hard, we think about our careers, we plan in that sense. When it comes to money and financial planning, it just seems to be a closed world to them.
The phenomenon that is short-termism is defined in psychology as our tendency to overvalue immediate rewards and undervalue long-term intentions. We tend to focus on our immediate financial needs and we forget our long-term plans, such as retirement. It looks so far ahead in the future and we tend to discount it.
We now think of something instant as a click, really is instant. It's not our parents' version of instant where you sent away for something or you had a think and you went out to a shop. You don't get any of that now. Everything is so compressed.
Digital culture has brought us incredible things. It's brought us the network, it's brought us the ability to kind of see all things at all times. We've become kind of omnipresent, but with that we've almost become never truly present.
There was a fantastic experiment done by some brilliant psychologists called the unforgettably named jam experiment. And they said, you know, when you've got the choice of three jams on sale, then you'll probably buy one. When you've got the choice of 18, you'll be so overwhelmed that you can't possibly choose one. So you'll tend to walk away with a sense of, oh, okay, I'll just have bread and butter, it'll do for now. That's kind of what we've got looped into now. We've got so much choice that it's becoming really difficult.
We think that lots of choice is a good thing, and I think what people are experiencing now is that they really don't want as much choice. They want people who will tell them what's good and what's not, and they don't want to have to spend their entire life searching through endless options.
Sitting down and doing some financial planning is a short-term act in itself, but what's the long-term vision of that? The long-term vision and the long-term gift of it is freedom.
So if we want to influence the reflective brain and manage our long-term plans better, we usually ask people to set up a goal, short-term and long-term goal, and also to create a plan, very specific plans, how to achieve this goal. And achieving this plan involves specifying where, when, and what you're going to do in specific situations.
When you plan, when you know what risk to take, when you've sat down, when you've done the figures, then you've got a real sense of freedom because you're kind of free of the anxiety. And that's a sense of true freedom, I think, and people don't realize it until they've actually done it.